This is Annabelle Gaberti and you are listening to Lawfully Creative, my podcast to talk with professionals in the creative industries to hear their stories, what inspires their creation, what decisions change their careers, what relationships influence their work. Today's episode is brought to you by Crefovi, our London and Paris-based law firm focused on advising the creative industries. Subscribe to our podcast, Lawfully Creative, or catch up with our original shows on iTunes, Spotify, Deezer, Stitcher, YouTube, Anchor, and many more podcast aggregators and platforms. Please do leave a review and rating about our podcast to encourage others to discover our curated content. Thank you. So I'm here with Juliette Espinasse-Dubois, the founder of Julie Saint Barthélemy, Julie Saint Barthélemy, which is a perfume brand as well as a hat brand, and now I understand also a dresses brand.
Yes.
What is the concept of your brand, Juliette?
Alors, I start in Saint Barth in 1989 with my hats.
So this is in the French
French island
close to the States.
In the Caribbean, yes.
In the Caribbean.
A very famous island, a very beautiful island. I live there for 10 years.
Okay.
And I start with my hats. And I sell a lot of hats in the beautiful... I have 10 hotels and shops who sell my hats there. And after, when I finish... I come back in Europe.
Yeah.
My dream was to have my perfumes because I am in perfumery and I want to work in perfumery since my childhood. Mm-hmm. So I come back in the region of Grasse.
Yeah.
And I want to create my perfumes.
So, because Grasse is very famous.
Yes.
As a center to create perfumes.
Yes.
And know about the essences.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So that's why I come back in Grasse, and I have a complete universe with my fashion and my perfumes.
So when you say your fashion, you mean the dresses that you create?
Yes.
So we were just talking about this because you're saying that you are going to have a fashion show this coming Friday.
Friday
the 24th. The 24th of January. Where is it going to be then?
Alors, my new fashion show for the Fashion Week Paris will be on Friday on the Galerie La Place, Rue Française, in the second arrondissement. It's a gallery of art where I sell my perfume there.
Okay.
And I will make a little show. And after, my big show in Paris is reported at the 1st of March.
Well, that makes sense.
Yes.
This is proper fashion week.
Yes.
Not proper, but like women's fashion week.
Yes, so because with the problem in Paris, the big show is reported.
What do you mean? Problems? What?
With the strike and the...
Oh, really? Voilà. Well, I don't think that it's going to be better in March for that.
But because I have someone who organizes all my big events.
Okay.
And he reported my big fashion show in March.
Because he thinks that it's going to be better in March?
I don't know, but he reports because he have a lot of very big partners like Mercedes or like a lot of partners.
Right.
And they all decide. There is a lot of other designers from Dubai and a lot of countries who come, and they decide to come in March
instead
of
true.
Now.
And that's always the case.
Voilà, it will be, it will be in a salle Erard.
Okay.
It's a concert salle, so a big place.
Okay, lovely, lovely. Right. Wait, so you're going to present your dresses, your hats,
and the perfumes.
And the perfumes are going to be worn by the models.
Yes, I am the only one, the designer, who presents the dress with the perfume and the hats.
Okay. Mm. And so...
That's my specificity.
And those dresses, do they also have like a sort of Caribbean style, like a beach style, or not really?
Alors, it's a prêt-à-porter of luxe. It's not haute couture. I try to have elegant dresses because I like elegance.
Okay, so it's not beach dresses.
Voilà. No, it's not beach dresses.
Okay.
I start before 1 year ago. I have some tunic beach dresses. I continue this, but now I want to have very elegant dress.
Okay. Mm. Okay, lovely. Mm. Great. Mm-hmm. So, I must admit, most of my questions are more focusing on the perfume mm-hmm. expertise. So, how did you get into perfumes? I read an article about you, an interview where you were saying that you've been in perfumes since you were a child. So, mm-hmm. how did this come about?
Alors, I started to take care of perfume since my 8 years because I started a collection of perfume.
Right.
And I have one of the very big collection of about 20,000 perfumes in my collection. And I have some
all in Grasse?
In my home.
I hope you have a good safe.
Yes.
Coffre fort.
Yes, it's not a problem. Before I have different places of my collection, but now I have all in Grasse.
Okay.
And I have a lot of friends or family who work in the perfume industry.
Right.
Since 30 years.
Okay.
So I decide to create my perfumes, and I am very an expert about perfume, about this collection, because I know every perfume in the world who arrive on the market.
Really? Because, so are you a nose?
Yes, I am nose.
Did you take the qualification as a nose? No. Because it's very competitive.
Yes, I don't study the chemist.
Okay.
But I have the feeling.
Right.
And I work with a very important perfumer like Jean-François Latty.
Who was a nose.
Mm-hmm. And I was very... I tell him what I want exactly because mm-hmm. I am a woman who knows what I want. And I have the feeling because I exerce myself to smell perfume since my 8 years and about 100 perfume mm-hmm. by day.
Mm-hmm. Right. Wow.
And I try to make my own creation.
Uh-huh.
And I think I have I am not a real nose, but I think I am a
it's
little
more like
nose.
Auto learning, but
yes.
Nonetheless. And so, do you actually this collection of 20,000 perfumes? Do you use them, or is it
no.
mostly for display?
Alors, I try them, of course, because I want to know every perfume, and I am fascinated by to smell perfume, but sometimes I open, sometimes I don't open. It depends of the if I have a very precious perfume for Lalique, so I don't
course,
open that.
Of course, yeah.
But it's like different perfumes. I buy perfume every day, and so I decide to create my own perfumes.
You buy perfumes every day.
Yes, because I make
on the internet.
On internet, enchères.
At auctions.
Auctions, yes.
Seriously, there are some auctions of perfumes.
Yes.
From which auction houses?
Every country, I buy on a website, on a different place, on a between collector.
So it's like vintage perfumes.
Yes, there is a lot of collector. Yes, who contact me. They sell some perfume,
and they want to buy. And
yes,
stuff.
Hmm?
Do you buy some?
I trade. And I am really an expert in perfumery because I know a lot of brand of perfume about
That's
my
fantastic.
Collection.
Because I'm far from your level, but I am interested in perfume.
Mm-hmm.
And this started, I mean, it started very early, but also a few years ago, my parents gave me a ticket to be able to go to the, I think, Gallimard
mm-hmm.
perfume house
mm-hmm.
in Grasse and to create my own perfume. So since I've been looking at, you know, how you do it and the story of creating
mm-hmm.
perfumes, and the point I wanted to make is that I read in one of the comic books I bought about perfume
mm-hmm.
making that there are around 1,000 perfumes coming out every year on the
yes,
market.
Yes, it's terrible.
Terrible, okay. Well, it's unbelievable.
Yes,
know, like
unbelievable.
1,000 perfumes per year.
Yes.
I wonder how many survive, you know?
Yes, but I think in the years is coming, I don't sure that a lot of brands will continue to sell
to flood the market.
Yes,
so many.
Yes, I think a few brands will stay. I think.
Mm. Mm. But so, what is your approach to buying perfume? Is it extremely expensive, very premium brands, or could it be also? Mm.
For my toilet, part, I want to sell to everybody, so I have two lines.
Okay.
Exclusive collection, very precious.
The ones you make, yeah?
No, and I have a first line.
Right. Here we're talking about the ones you are making, not the...
No, the both. My perfumes, my creation.
Your perfumes, yes.
I start with a first collection, but the price is 50 euros.
Okay.
20 euros the miniature.
Okay.
And 95 the big size.
Mm-hmm.
So I think for a perfume of creator, it's really a good affordable. And after, I decide to make an exclusive collection.
Okay.
Fantastic fragrance of exception, and a very nice cap, very nice packaging, and yeah, of course it's more expensive.
And but I
want to create perfume for everybody, and I create also perfume for overbrand.
For
overbrands.
Overbrands
of if you come to see me, and you want I create your perfume.
You customize perfumes, is what
yes,
you're saying.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. On request, on order.
I make perfume for a personality, mm-hmm, for some person who want to marry and they want to offer mm-hmm perfumes
to the guests,
or for a shop, or for different... A lot of persons contact me to create your perfume.
Right, so you're almost like a perfume consultant as well.
Yes, of course.
That's fantastic. And I remember I met you 2 years ago at Tranoy.
Mm-hmm.
Probably actually in January,
yes,
2017, because you were exhibiting there. So Tranoy mm-hmm is a very famous fashion trade show which happens 3 or 4 times a year.
Yes,
in January for Men's Fashion Week, mm-hmm, then in March, which is the biggest women session for Fashion Week,
mm-hmm,
and then again sometimes they do June, July, sometimes not if I remember well, and then there's of course the mm-hmm a second women's session in September. So was it difficult to get into Tranoy? Was it easy for you? And are you still going to Tranoy?
I expose 2 times in Tranoy. And this year, they asked me to expose again. But this year, I decide to expose in near London, in Birmingham, to change a little.
Oh, in the NIC? In
Spring Fair. I will be in Spring Fair this year. To change because
which is in February, yeah.
Voilà. Ah, oui, I will be in London at the end of the month, and I make a Spring Fair this year. I decide to change and to find another market.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
But I like very much Tranoy, and
yeah,
I would like to make
focus
Tranoy. I will contact Tranoy again, maybe for next year, or I would like to make Tranoy Shanghai, maybe also.
Yeah, are they doing Tranoy Shanghai now?
Yes.
In China? That's
yes,
interesting.
Yes,
okay.
I think it can be very interesting.
Okay.
Because I also exposed on the Who's Next a few years ago also. But I think
in
France, the show in France, we see a lot of persons, but we don't have a lot of orders. I think...
Are just coming
from the French brand?
Yeah.
We need to make sure in the other countries.
Okay.
Because I think we are famous for perfumes and the couture.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it will be a good thing for a brand like me to expose in other countries.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Coming back to, so did you actually do some studies? Did you go to some like courses on about beauty, about fashion, cosmetics when you were a teenager?
I am autodidact.
Okay,
autodidact.
Completely
autodidact. I study a little economy.
Okay.
I am a businesswoman.
Okay.
And I study also a little journalist also, because
okay,
I make also a magazine.
Okay.
So, voilà. And I am autodidact in creation, but I create for 30 years now.
Yeah.
So I think I have a big experience also in perfume and in fashion, and I create a lot of models each year.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. So how do you compose your perfumes? Do you have a theme? Do you have a sort of idea in mind of what you want it to smell like, or a particular target in the market, or who you want to sell it to? What is the thinking or creating process?
The first thing when you want to create a perfume is to know the idea you want to see, the flower you want to use. It's
mm-hmm
absolutely necessary to know what you want. For my part, some perfume was a lot of my memories. My first perfume, Shell Beach, was my memories of Saint Bart, mm-hmm. and I want to use certain flowers, certain notes that I like. And after,
is it because your parents moved there that you?
No, it's me. I moved in Saint Bart my husband.
Oh, okay, when you were young,
My mother was in fashion.
Okay,
but after she was in the car industry. My parents.
Automotive.
Yes.
Okay. So, and were you originally from Paris or?
No. I am originaire from Le Touquet in the north of the France.
I see. So this is Normandy.
Voilà. Right. But after I come back, I come in the region of Grasse.
Right.
When I was 18.
Okay.
With my.
Did you enjoy it?
Yes, of course.
Because I went to Grasse in September
mm-hmm.
to visit a museum, which was fantastically interesting.
Yes,
museum
yes. Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's the second time I visited. The first time I thought it was a letdown, that it wasn't really interested. But this time around, it was fantastic.
Yes.
There
is a very some nice exposition.
Yeah, really good. Mm-hmm. Really useful. I suppose when I visited the first time around, it was just being created, etc. So it was not great. But this time around, in September 2019, it was tip-top. But what I felt about the city of Grasse itself was that like it's a bit of a dead city, you know. It's like a very, like lots of tourists, but not it doesn't seem like a lot of people are actually living in it.
Alors, yes, there is a lot of problem in Grasse, but I think
And the population who lives there seems to be pretty poor.
Yes, yes, but there is some also nice people in Grasse. It depends.
There are two different. Nice, but
voilà. But I think to be present in Grasse, it's important, and I think there is a lot of avenir in Grasse because it's a dynamic city with the mayor of the city.
Okay.
Voilà.
And with the museum.
With the museum, there is a lot of dynamism. Yeah. Renew of the city, uh-huh. and I think to be present for me in Grasse for my marketing in is important to be perfumer in Grasse. It's a legitimacy on the capital of the.
Do you think it's still the capital of the world of perfumes?
Yes, of course. Yeah. Yes.
Which other towns are the competitors?
I think there is some places overseas. It's nice also to be in Paris, but
for perfume creation, Paris really. And what about overseas? Because I was thinking, some people are saying Grasse is no longer the capital, the world capital of perfume. But then I said, I'm thinking, then who else? Who else is the capital of perfume?
For me, Grasse is the capital of the perfumes, and I think still, and you have the wonderful flowers. In Grasse, and in my perfumes, I really take care about the beautiful flower of the Pays of Grasse. It's very important for me. I work very hard with the jasmine of Grasse, and my new perfume will be at the Tubéreuse.
You can still buy it from there? I thought they were being bought overseas.
I just received the medal of Grasse expertise.
Wonderful.
So
congratulations.
Yes.
What does it entail?
It's important because we take care of the Pays of Grasse,
mm-hmm.
and we represent in the world this quality of perfumes, this quality of flowers.
Mm-hmm. Do you know also what I did?
For the UNESCO also.
Oh, lovely. Mm-hmm. Well, on this note, actually, when I was there, I went to Montsartou and I visited the garden, you know.
Oh, yes. I love this place.
It was so lovely. I really enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. It was a bit complicated because I didn't have a car, so I had to go by train, which was a drag. But honestly, the gardens of the Musée de la Parfumerie in Montsartou, fantastic.
I love this place.
I spent 2 or 3 hours.
I go there very often.
Oh, you do?
It's one of my favorite places in the French Riviera.
Yeah.
Because I like to be in the flowers. Yeah. And I have a few friends who have field of flowers, and I like to go there.
Oh, yeah, it's really lovely. Mm-hmm. I do. Okay, so at 18, you moved for a brief time to Grasse.
Mm-hmm. And after, my husband was very asthmatic, and we decided to live in Saint Bart,
which was good for a lot of air stuff.
Yes, and I would like to make my perfumerie in Grasse 30 years ago, but it was not possible. So when we go in Saint Barth, I only take care of hats and fashion.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I come back recently, 6 years ago in Grasse.
Okay.
And I was happy to realize my dream to have my perfumery in Grasse.
Okay, so you only started making perfumes like 6 years ago. You've done a lot.
Yes.
You've made a lot of headway.
Yes, yes,
in 6 years.
It was my dream for a long, long time.
Yeah, but you were not close to where the, you could find the providers and the
expertise. Yes, exactly.
How awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, so how do you basically sound the market for trends? How do you gather the data to know what the customers want?
Alors, it's important, to know the tendance. It's like in fashion,
the trends.
It's important to have the trends, but also your own story, I think, and to be legitimate in the story of the brand. So I take care of the trends, of course, but each perfume I create have a story near my brand, near my.
So do you mind giving us an example of one story?
Yes, for me, the perfume I create, Une Roseraie Française.
Mm-hmm.
My parents have a roseraie in
Le Touquet.
In Le Touquet. And I take care of them.
Uh-huh.
And it's a very nice memory for me. But I would like in Une Roseraie Française to have the Rose of Grasse, the Rose of May. And I walk the Centifolia. Voilà.
What is Centifolia?
The Centifolia is the rose of the Pays of Grasse.
Okay. Okay.
Voilà.
It's funny actually you say that that your parents have a roseraie, so this place where they grow roses in the Normandy, because I went to Granville.
Granville Dior Garden.
Exactly. Well, to see the Grand Garden and see the exhibition about Grace of Monaco.
Yes.
Which was really interesting.
Ah, yes.
And I noticed that there were lots of roses there.
Right.
in Granville, which is also in Normandy.
It's a very nice garden. I love this place.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was really, really cute indeed.
Mm-hmm.
So are you saying that basically when you want to make a perfume, it's more like an inward looking process as opposed to what do outside customers want?
This is one perfume. I take care of the trends. It's more the oud mystérieux. My perfume oud mystérieux,
like more because, oriental.
Yes, more oriental, because I know a lot of person like oudy fragrance.
Mm-hmm.
So I work very hard to make this oud mystérieux that is a little different than the other oud, because it's a dry oud, unisex.
Okay.
Voilà, but this perfume, I because a lot of person ask me about oud, so I make this perfume.
Okay. But from the Middle East, people from the Middle East.
Yes.
Yeah, of
yes, course. Of course. Voilà.
Yeah.
But normally, I would like to create unique perfumes with my feelings, my story. Voilà.
It's unbelievable how, various cultures have got various tastes in perfumes.
Mm.
So, for example, when I was at the Gallimard lab to create my own perfume, it was very interesting what the ladies, they're the chemists, you know, who help you make the perfume, were saying. And they were saying the people from the Middle East, they like very sugary perfumes, very like heavy perfumes, which are going to smell, miles away. The Americans, they like more fruity. Europeans, they tend to, they all have it. It was really quite, and they had difficulty in finding actually where to locate my own perfume, my own creation, actually, in which place to put it. But so, and it's true, I remember once I was just on a Sunday night, I think on Saturday night, I was just walking on close to the Harrods, on Knightsbridge, and so where there are lots of, in summer, there are lots of people from the Middle East there, because it's far too hot in Dubai or...
Yes.
Right. in those places, so they come to London or Paris, and my gosh, the smell of these perfumes that these women were, although I'm not closer to them than 1.5 meters, but I can smell their perfumes from far away, and for me, it really is over the top. It's really too much. But so it's interesting to see the difference in tastes.
In different countries, And I, in Grasse, this summer, I meet some Indian person.
Okay.
And it was also different.
A discovery. Right. So what do they like, the Indians? Like from India?
Yes. Alors, recent, they want different...
Patchouli.
Patchouli or Strong perfume, voilà.
Strong perfume as well.
And just recently, last week, I have some Indian person who quite some essence of lemon and orange. So
fruity.
Oui, fruity. Lovely. Different. Oui, oui. Interesting.
So, where is your biggest market, buying market at the moment? Mm-hmm. Where do you sell most?
It's different for the perfume and for the hats and for the fashion.
Okay.
But so I have 30 shops in the world who distribute my hats and my perfumes.
Okay.
And there is some in France, in Caribbean, in United States.
But do you have some stats about who buys your perfumes? Some data?
Yeah, I think my brand. I have five perfumes for men, unisex.
As well.
So okay. I think there is a large quantity of persons different who can buy my perfumes.
Are they usually Europeans? Are they usually from the Middle East? Are they usually Americans?
Yes,
it's varied.
Varied, yes, okay. It's varied. Right.
And so, what is the? Do you have like a bestseller?
Sincerely, I sell a lot all my perfumes. It depends. My perfume Shell Beach is one of my bestsellers. Une roseraie française.
What is it made of, Shell Beach?
Shell Beach is with guapfruit, lemon, bergamot. Very, very fresh.
Guapfruit?
Guapfruit. Grapefruit. Yes.
Oh, grapefruit.
Grapefruit.
Right.
And I have.
And what did you say? Bergamot?
Bergamot, lemon.
Okay, super fresh.
And,
Did you put some
orange blossom also?
Orange blossom. Mm-hmm. No smell of the sea.
I make this perfume with Jean-François Latty. So,
okay. Who is famous for?
Yes, for l'eau dynamisante of Clarins, oh, okay. Saint Laurent Jazz.
Is he based in Grasse as well?
No, he's died now. Oh, but it was a very, very fantastic perfumer, nose, exceptional nose.
Right.
And a very nice person.
Mm-hmm.
And I work with him and I tell him I want more web food. So we work.
So this one is quite a bestseller. The beach.
Une roseraie française in Grasse is my bestseller
because okay. Because you've got the shop
the rose
there,
of Grasse.
Right?
Yes, I have my perfumerie in Grasse where I make also my workshop.
Okay.
You can come in my shop to create your unique perfume in about 2 hours.
Okay.
But in the notes, July of Saint Barth, mm-hmm. because I work also some. Exotic notes, fragrance, and you can
exotic
voilà, because
notes.
We make a concept.
Like what?
Frangipanier.
Wow.
Voilà,
frangipanier. Does it have smell?
Oui, yes. A lot of flowers of grass because I love the flowers.
Macadamia
nuts. But coconut.
Oh, lovely.
Voilà, we can. It's a Nike workshop we can make also in my perfumerie.
Sounds
I have in the main place of Grasse, Place Auxerre, the mm-hmm. main place of the historic center.
Uh-huh.
It's a perfumerie, a big perfumerie.
I can't believe I missed it when I was there in September.
It's a concept store.
Okay.
So you have fashion. You have fashion also. You have perfumes.
Okay.
And also decoration. Voilà. I am near Molinar and Mikalev on the main place of Grasse.
Yeah, no, I do remember visiting mm-hmm. Molinar. Okay, awesome. Mm-hmm. And this you achieved in 6 years.
I project to open my own other shops also, but it's a surprise for
another shop.
Another shop.
Also in Grasse?
No.
Okay.
No.
Fingers crossed for that. That sounds
yes.
great. And all this you achieved in 6 years.
Alors, in 6 years, I have 30.
When you came back?
Yes, when I come back in my work.
Yeah. So you came back in 2013, 2014.
Yes,
yeah.
14.
All this you did in 6 years.
Yes, because
that's fantastic.
In 6 years, I succeeded to have 30 shops in the world who distribute my
stockists. Yeah. Yeah.
And,
where are they based?
To open my own perfumerie in Grasse.
That's fantastic.
And I think I'm going to open one or two other one.
Mm-hmm. You mean shops?
Shops.
Retail points.
Yes.
And so in terms of the stockists, where are they based usually? Are they,
I work with perfumerie, hotels, fashion store,
okay.
concept store,
okay.
different.
How do you approach them? Are they people you met through Tranoy, through Usnet?
Yes, all the show I make in the world, I succeed to have a lot of customers who buy my perfume. Okay. And also with the fashion show. The fashion show I make.
The draws voilà. Some clients.
Yes, yes.
And usually are these stockist based close to the sea or to resorts, to sea resorts or not really?
Different on the sea, but also in the
cities.
Cities. Okay. Different.
Wow. Mm-hmm. That's excellent. That's a good mm-hmm. portfolio to have mm-hmm. a good mix. Mm-hmm.
I make the show in Dubai, Beauty World.
Yeah.
But it was interesting. I make a show in Japan. But for the moment, I'm discussing.
Do the Japanese also enjoy your perfumes?
I make...
That's a good clientele to have.
Yes, yes. I make a show last year in Japan. It was, I don't remember, the show in international congrès yeah. in Tokyo. Right. Awesome. A show of fashion when I expose my hat and my perfumes.
Because they're very good in perfumes like Comme des Garçons, etc.
Yes, yes. Really, I hope really I can.
Awesome perfumes.
I have to renew the contact and I hope yeah. to find places in Japan.
Mm-hmm. Great. So, why the name Julie of Saint Barth? Is that coming from.
Alors, I created this name 30 years ago because my name is Juliette, but I want something. Short, so I decided July because of the month of July of Saint Barth.
So it's actually not Julie, it's July.
Wait, a lot of persons call me Julie or July, depends. Okay. When I was in Saint Barth, the American person called me July.
Oh, okay.
But in fine. France, it's more Julie.
I hope you trademark that, July of Saint Barth. How do you, as you may know, I'm actually a fashion lawyer, okay? So, of course, the inevitable sort of more like legal question is going to come up. And so I know that perfumes can be protected, perfumes formula, mm-hmm. Usually for copyright. Mm. I don't think any patent has been ever, of course, registered, but through copyright. So how do you make sure that you protect your formulas, you know, with your manufacturers who make the perfume, etc. Mm. How do you make sure that it's all being kept secret?
Yes, I work with the manufacturer and we take care of this, of course. But the more important thing, of course, is the name of my brand. I protect the name of my brand.
As a trademark, yeah.
Voilà, and the trademark. And the formula also, it's important, but I work with the manufacturer and yeah. we take care together of this.
Right. Mm-hmm. So is that manufacturer based in Grasse?
Yes, of course, in the pays of Grasse.
Okay, so surely there must be...
I work with different labs.
Okay.
It depends on the perfume I want to create.
Yeah.
And after, I have a different place when I want. It depends... of what I want to do.
Yes, yeah, so they are used I have places a, voilà, to I confidentiality.
Have, voilà, of course. Of course. Mm.
Sorry, you were about to say? Sorry. Mm.
I work with different manufacturers and different labs. It depends on different perfumeurs. Mm-hmm. It depends of the story of the perfume. Voilà.
Why?
Because I know there is some lab or some manufacturer or more specialized in one flower.
I see.
One... perfume.
Gosh, if you don't voilà. Even grass, this voilà. Is not something.
And sometimes I want to make a collab with another perfumer. It's interesting. The last perfume I launched was Joie Éternelle, and I work with Nathalie Festower, that is a very famous perfumer. L'Eau des Merveilles de Hermès.
Oh, wow. Of Hermès. Course. I think the blonde woman, yeah?
No.
She's
no.
not blonde?
No.
Okay.
No.
I'll Google her.
She work here in Paris in Montmartre. We work together on my last perfume, Joie Éternelle. But it's a very nice creation, and I sell a lot this perfume also.
Fantastic.
And voilà.
When I went to the Musée de la Parfumerie in September, I noticed that Louis Vuitton now has a house. Mm-hmm. They make perfumes now, which is quite recent. They didn't mm-hmm. used to make perfumes before. And so there's apparently a father with his daughter who is, he's a nose, he's based in Grasse. Mm-hmm. And they have, like, every image is
I think Vuitton
castle.
Is made by Mr. Cavalier.
I think that might be right. A guy in his 50s who's got white hair and he's got his daughter who is also working with him.
I see all the perfumeurs in the MIP when there is the famous exposition Eau de Cologne.
Yes.
Everybody was here and I was there.
Okay. I think that's the one I visited actually.
Voilà.
Yeah.
And for the inauguration, I was there, and all the perfumer was there.
Okay, so was that chap around? Was he there?
Yes.
Okay, with his daughter, probably.
Yes.
So apparently, LVMH has bought this castle, and they are making it as their atelier workshop to create all the perfumes with this guy with a nose and his daughter who is training under him.
Mm. Oh, it's interesting. Right? There is a lot of.
Is he famous in the industry, that guy?
Yes, of course.
Who does Louis Vuitton perfumes?
Oh, oui, of course, very famous.
Okay.
Very famous. So,
and you do have a network of you socialize with, I mean, like you tend to see them or?
I think I am the new little brand of the perfumerie.
In six years already you've achieved an enormous amount.
I think in 6 years I make a good job and I make a nice job and a lot of people know me now. I think I progress. I have a decoration of art and culture.
What does that mean?
I was decorated in Paris at the Hotel Georges V in October.
Lovely.
By the Divine Academy.
Okay.
And I am ambassadress of art and culture for my work in fashion and perfumer.
And who gives that?
Alors, it's an ambassador of the Maroc.
Okay.
And on this nice evening, there is a lot of ambassador was there. Ambassador for United States, ambassador...
You are good with PR, this is excellent.
Mozambique also was there. And there is a lot also of... They decorated a lot of painting artists also. But I was the only one perfumer on this
evening. Very creative types. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Congratulations. So what is the future for your brand in terms of... Okay, alors, so you said that now you're also going through...
My future... voilà. Alors, my future, I will have my dresses and my complete universe with the perfume, the hats and the fashion.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a very nice new this week because I have the Principality of Monaco who select me for the Fashion Week in Monte Carlo in May. On the official.
Okay.
Because this is 30 years I make fashion show in the world.
Is it the Italian lady who runs it, runs the show?
Italian lady. But I was...
And Davide Jais, is he still part of the committee or was he left now?
I was with the man of Stardust, the joaillerie.
Right, okay, I haven't come across
it. He's also in the Champs Modégas of the Couture.
Oh, right. I actually attended the Monte Carlo fashion show 2 years ago and I presented
the fashion I am very proud because they selected me.
But for what? For a défilé?
Yes.
For a catwalk show?
Yes.
For your dresses?
Yes.
Okay. Well, that makes total sense since you are in Grasse.
Yes, because I make a very nice défilé in Grasse where I have a lot of personnes in August.
Yeah.
And I think there is a lot of article about my fashion show everywhere in the world. So
I
make also the fashion show in New York.
What is the name of this Italian lady? I think she's got a shop in Monte Carlo, isn't she? Fashion shop. Stefania or okay. Wow, fantastic! Well, that's
and
great.
That's an
opportunity. But how do you see the brand evolving? Do you want to, you were saying before, you want to have more shops?
No, what I would like to, I'm continue to make some fashion show to have more shops, but I really would like to have the support of an industrial. I would like to have...
Everybody wants to have the support of a big conglomerate group.
Yes, it's difficult alone to continue and to have more shops and... To distribute alone.
Yeah, right. Of course.
Right.
Of
course. So I would like to have the support of someone.
Yeah. And so you're basically doing everything. You're doing like the business side, the PR,
I have a lot of collaborators. Yes. But I have collaborators in a lawyer. I have collaborators in a lot of domains.
Mm-hmm.
But I am alone. And I have some collaborators, a lot of domains, but they make me a bill and an invoice.
Yeah.
But I would like, when I'm going to have more shops, I'm going to quite.
Well, actually, work. LVMH, brought into his roster quite recently Francis Curjean.
Mm-hmm.
But Francis Curgeon is a double team. So there's Francis who does all the creation. He's the nose and he's done, you know, lots of perfumes. So for Jean-Paul Gaultier. And his works are in tandem with a guy who I think is from ESSEC. And so a French business school. And he does, this other guy does all the business.
I think
aspects.
The one also Atelier Cologne.
And they are very aggressive. Right. Very aggressive indeed. So like you've never seen how aggressive they are, but hey, at the end of the day, they just got acquired by LVMH, so it seems to be working out.
I think a brand like also Atelier Cologne, who have the support now of L'Oréal.
I don't know them. Alors, where are they based?
They were based in Paris.
Okay.
And they, L'Oréal distribute them now in the, all over the world, Atelier Cologne.
Okay.
And I think it's a nice example for France.
There's also Biredo, the guy from Biredo, you know, the Swedish Indian guy is doing really great with Biredo and he's opening shops everywhere as
Yes, I know. I know because I see their shops in Florida.
In Florida and also in Paris.
In Paris.
As far as I'm concerned now, I enjoy making my own perfume. So, seriously, I mean, and so I buy a lot of essential oils, in particular from Aromazone.
Yes.
I love Champaca, for example.
Yes.
Champaca is fantastic.
I have Champaca in the Joie Eternelle. Magnolia Champaca.
It's so interesting. I think it comes from Mexico, does it not?
From my Champaca, it comes from Asia.
Asia. And so, so I buy all these essential oils. And I have made a perfume but using as a base like oil, but now I want to do it with alcohol. The only thing is that you can't import alcohol in the UK.
I
don't know why, but they just don't want you to buy alcohol. So,
alcohol
like, if
is
you
a problem to export on the...
Even if you go to a chemist in London, they can't sell you some bottles of 90 degree or 70 degrees alcohol. Unbelievable.
It's very complicated.
Do you know why?
For the regulation on the plane and everything, it's very complicated.
Maybe they're concerned that people might turn it into a bomb.
It's very complicated. I was thinking about oily perfume that I don't know.
Frankly, I did it only because I couldn't have access to alcohol, really. But
and I am also interested also by the International Fragrance Foundation.
Okay.
Because you can see on LinkedIn.
Okay.
I know this woman. It's very interesting because she wants to take care of the natural perfume. And
right.
Because the industry of perfume only work with chemie.
Because I said essential oils, why you are thinking
so,
natural.
I'm thinking about a natural perfume. The problem, the regulation, European regulation, it's not authorized. But they want to change the...
Perfume?
Yes. It's no sense for me.
So are you saying that all the... what you are saying is that all the fragrances are basically reproduced in a chemical manner?
It's a mixed. Generally, it's a mixed.
Right.
For me, my perfume, it's a mixed.
But
I would like, in the future, maybe to make a perfume only natural. And I'm going to work on this. But I would like the European regulation.
And you're saying at the moment it's not possible?
No. If you make a natural perfumer, you are no in the law.
Why?
Because it's the industry of the perfume. Now...
Do you think they've been lobbying so that you have to add some chemicals?
But
some...
you can see this Fragrance Foundation. I will send you the link.
Okay. And so they are good because they promote natural
perfumes?
Because,
they want to promote the natural version perfumes.
Yeah.
And I'm going to see a woman work in only natural perfume. And maybe I would like to do it.
So now I have my perfume for... Nice, which I've created, which is a lot of sea, you know, sea smells, etc. Lavender as well, obviously.
Yes.
You know, all the smells that I smell in the south of France. So I've put in this perfume. So it's in my flat in Nice. Mm-hmm. I've got my perfume for London, you know, with also more like robust smells or even like tobacco smells. And and now I need to create one for Paris as well.
Yes. In my family, my name is Espinasse. If you come back in Grasse, you can see I have a very old object in my perfume from lavender,
okay,
in the Luberon, because my ancestor, du côté de Espinasse,
uh-huh,
was a producer of lavender.
Right, lovely.
Very, very long times ago. Oh,
so your family is not originally from Le Touquet? I mean,
no, the family of my husband.
Okay.
Was originaire from the Luberon, Aix-en-Provence.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
And they have, and the, with my husband, we used to have a lot of lavender fields. Yes, in the Luberon.
And like, as in you owned them?
Yes.
So you had to sell them?
Yes. Yes, but we sell this property.
Okay.
But we have, long time ago, a lot of espinas who produce the lavender.
Indeed, it's a very particular, right,
picture. So I think I am... it's a nice story.
Yeah.
Of flowers.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Thank you for giving so much, you know, energy and passion into the perfume industry, and you also your take on it. And good luck also with your new lines in prêt-à-porter.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll come back to you, Wendy.
I'm very happy to meet you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for listening to our podcast, Lawfully Creative, produced by Crefobi Studios. Subscribe to our podcast or catch up with our original shows on iTunes, Spotify, Deezer, Stitcher, YouTube, Anchor, and many more podcast aggregators and platforms. Please leave a review and rating about our podcast to encourage others to discover our curated content. Thank you.